Chapter 3, Section 5, increase and decrease problem.
I think it's spelling anymore.
Chapter 3, Section 5, increase and decrease problem. Increase problems, keywords, after an increase of, more than, greater than. Those are some words that you look for if you know, to know it's a an increase problem. A decrease problem, keywords you look for is after a decrease of, less than, after a reduction of.
Can't see it. Throw the cat at the dog.
Increase problem. The base for 100% plus a percentage of the base gives a new value, which is the total. Okay, in an increase problem, the base, okay, we've talked about the base, the original amount, the B. Okay, do you remember the B and B equals B times R problems? Okay, that was a couple sections. We just took a quiz over it. Now we're going to use that base, and then we're going to add the percentage of the base, which what variable stood for the percentage of the base in our problems? R was the percent. What was the percentage of the base? The part, the P. Okay? So we're going to take the B and then add the P to get a new value, which is our total. Now, original plus increase is my total. So my original is that B plus my P, okay, which we just talked about, that variable, which is the part or percentage of that base, equals the total. Well, here I just took the percentage of the base and plugged it in for P. Remember we said P equals B times R. So I have B plus D times R equals T. Okay, then I'm going to go fish. Okay, how many of you have Mrs. Yoder and have fished before? Uh-huh. Never had Mrs. Yoder. What that means is you're going to factor out a term. Okay, do you have common term in B and BR? What's my common term?
Okay, go fish.
B. I have a common term B. So I'm going to fish out a B in each term. I'm going to pull out a B here, and I'm going to pull out a B here. And I'm going to rewrite my equation, B times 1 plus R. Okay? It's basically what fishing and factoring is just the distributive property backwards. Okay? If I were to do the distributive property now, I'd take B times 1 and get B, plus B times R and get BR. I do the distributive property backwards. Okay, I factored out a B. I plugged in BR for P. Because P equals BR. I think we did that for days. Now let's do a problem. Let's complete a problem.
Oh, okay.
Got it? Light bulb moment. Alright. The price of a home sold by real estate agent Tricia Marinero this year was $187,000. This is which is 10% more than last year's value. Find the value of the home last year. Alright, so I have 10%. I know that's my R. Okay, I'm going to use my equation. B, I can use any three, but most of the time you're going to use the bottom one. Okay, if you use the bottom one, it usually requires less steps, okay, in order to solve. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in B times 1 plus R equals T. Which is my total? Is it my, or is $187,000, is that my total or my B? My B. Think about it. Is that my original price, or is it my price after the increase? So which one is it? It's the original plus the increase, so it's my total. So I have $187,000 after my increase. Well, what is my increase? It's 1 plus 10%, or 0.1, times the original amount. I don't know my original amount. Right, Hillier? How do I solve for B? Divide by 1.1, or... It's going to be 1.1. Who's going to be my calculator operator today? Louis? 187,000 divided by 1.1. $170,000. So B equals $170,000. Does that make sense? Last year was $170,000. The price increased 10%, and this year she sold it for $187,000. Does that make sense? Yeah, sure. If it increased. There you go. The hard part is determining between which value in your problem is the total and which value is the base. Okay, that's the tough part. Once you get the hang of that, problem starts with that. All right, let's try another one. Sales of Icon's newest web enabling device have grown by 20% per year for each of the past 2 years. If 93,600 are sold this year, find sales 2 years ago. Okay? So I have to find growth per year was 20%, right? And I need to find 2 years back. Common mistake. When you have two increases, you cannot add the increases together. You cannot write your equation B times 1 plus R equals T. You cannot put 40% in for R. 20% 1 year, 20% the next, oh, it's been a 40% increase. No. Okay? That is not the case. You actually have to do the equation twice. You had to find out 1 year with a 20% increase, and you have to do it again. Okay? You have to do it every time, however many years you have. We're going to start with our first year, okay? This year, they sold 93,600, okay? So I know that that's 20% more, 1 plus 0.2, right, 1.2, 93,600, okay? So last year, whatever 93,600 divided by 1.2, write that, though, but yeah, 1.2, what is that, Louis? 93,600 divided by 1.2?
$78,000
even? So after I go back 1 year, I know that sales last year were 78,000. Okay, but I want 2 years back, so I have to do it again. Okay, so I have to divide that number by 1.2 as well. So this is 20% increase again. So I'm going to take 78,000 divided by 1.2. What do you get, Louis?
65,000.
So 2 years ago, they sold 65,000 web-enabling devices. That would be, you'd have to do it twice, not a two-part answer, because if they say what were the sales last year and the year before, that would be a two-part answer, but they said five sales 2 years ago. So you first have to find it 1 year ago, then you go back 2 years. All right, let's talk about decrease. Those were increase, now let's do some decrease problems. Decrease is the exact same thing. I actually copied the notes page for the increase, and I just changed a couple words. One, the plus sign changes to minus. Okay? It's the base, 100%, minus a percentage of that base, which is that P, okay, gives you a new total. So it's original minus your decrease amount. Okay, that's what you do when you have a sale. It's a 20% off sale, something you're buying. Okay, you take the original price and you subtract out whatever that percentage off is, and there you have it. So the only difference between our equation for increase and our equation for decrease, or our formula, is the minus sign. Thank you. All right, I'm going to read this first and I'll tell you what the common mistake is. After Fleet Feet deducted 10% from the price of a pair of running shoes, Craig Blyer paid $135. What was the original price of the shoes?
Does that make a supplement a difference?
What's that?
You had the other supplement last page, I didn't get it.
I'm sorry, did I go too fast? There you go. I didn't go through the formulas because they're exactly the same. I'm doing the exact same steps. Okay, and I did for increase, except I have a minus sign in there instead of a plus sign. I've already read the problem, didn't I? You guys are with me here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we have a pair of shoes for $135. Those are 10% off the original price. So I'm going to use my formula. B times 1 minus R equals T. What's that? Well, think about it. Right. My original price is going to be my B. Okay. So your sale price is going to be your T. Because this is a decrease problem. In the end, you're going to end up with a smaller number than you do in the beginning, your B. Okay. That's the common mistake, is to switch the B and the T in a decrease problem. Okay. Be very careful. So in this case, I don't know my B. I think in most of the problems, you are looking for B. I think in most all the problems. And I know that my, oops, I forgot to plug in R. What is my rate? What was the discount on the shoes? 10% or 0.1 equals 135. So I have B times 0.9 equals 135 divided by 0.9, Lori.
150.
So the original price of the shoes was $150. All right, we're going to do one more example and then we'll get started. All right, everybody get that problem? Okay, all you auto mechanic people out there. In a recent test of an automobile anti-lock braking system, or also known as ABS, okay, on wet pavement, the stopping distance was 114 feet. If this was 28.75% less than the distance needed to stop the same automobile without this ABS, find the distance needed to stop without the anti-lock braking system. Okay, so we're at a decrease problem. Okay, what tells me that it's a decrease problem? Less than. Okay, so I know I'm going to use B equals 1 minus R. B times 1 minus R equals T. What's my total? Or what's my base and what's my rate? Right. 114 is my total. That is the distance that the car with anti-lock braking system traveled, which was percentage less than what the one without anti-lock braking system traveled. So I have 114, 1 minus 0.2875 times B. Okay, B times the 0.7125, I think. Divided by 0.7125. How far can the car without an anti-lock braking system, how far do they need to brake?
160 feet.
So the car without needs 160 feet. The car with ABS needs 114.
Yeah,
what's that?
That's a big difference.
Yeah, that's a pretty big difference. I would suggest ABS for your car. Okay, when might you use these, like, every day? When do things increase and when do things decrease? What things increase? What? Yep, increase, decrease. Yeah, definitely if it's on sale, That you wish you that you had a 30% coupon, I bet. Ooh, nice. Yeah, if you have a sale coupon from Kohl's, 30%. Haven't gotten one in a while. I'm getting anxious. All right, what else? What else increases or decreases? Stocks, yes. Gas prices. Those go up, food prices. What decreases?
Jobs.
Jobs. That was a good answer. Yeah, jobs are decreasing. Okay, they have always have a percentage of decrease, don't they? Okay, well, how would you find out how many jobs were last year? You just plug it into your formula. Okay, depending what information they give you. Okay, your homework is on page 101, 102. It's 1 through 20. You guys have quite a bit of time to get started.
Can you say the homework again?